In this video, we will be going over the basic steps for running a factor analysis in SPSS. In social science research, we often cannot directly measure some social concepts. For example, there is no way to directly measure the amount of depression a person has. However, we can ask questions about their mood or their eating habits to get an idea of how their depression is affecting them. Thus, researchers have created statistical procedures to analyze a set of data for common factors called a factor analysis, which we can run in SPSS. Factor analysis is used to analyze the variable relationships for complex social concepts. It helps identify underlying factors in a data set. It can be used to explore patterns in the data and help create hypotheses for more in-depth analysis. It can also be used to reduce a data set into a smaller number of factors that explain the majority of the variable's variance. In a sample survey, we asked questions about income, education, and career. These questions all have one factor in common. We would most likely call this factor socioeconomic status, as we reasonably know that these questions are usually indicators of lifestyle and wealth. SPSS analyzes all the answers to your survey questions and identifies patterns of responses to find associations to these underlying factors. Factor loading occurs when it seems like many of the variables have a strong association to particular factors. SPSS produces an output similar to the one above that shows the factors that our variables are loading onto. Going back to our survey, we also asked about the area these participants live in. As we can see, there are two factors that SPSS is identifying. In this case, factor 1 may be related to individual socioeconomic status, and factor 2 may be related to the neighborhood socioeconomic status. SPSS may pick up more than two factors depending on the strength of the associations. Now, let's run a factor analysis in SPSS. Here we have a data file of a survey about gender identity. We are going to run a factor analysis of all the variables or questions in the survey. In the SPSS menu bar, click Analyze. And point to Dimension Reduction. Select Factor. Next, select the second variable. Hold down the Shift key and select the last variable. Use the arrow button to move all the variables in your survey into the Variables box. Next, click Rotation. There are many ways to rotate a factor analysis. However, we will not be going over them in this video. Each rotation will produce a different type of output, so make sure you understand the statistical theory behind the rotation you are using. In our case, we are using Varimax. When you have finished selecting your rotation, click Continue. Then, select Options. Here, we can sort the results and suppress small coefficients, so SPSS will ignore weak associations. Set SPSS to suppress small coefficients. Enter 0.30 in the absolute value below text box. This is the lowest threshold for weak associations. Click Continue to go back to the factor analysis window. Then, click OK to run the test. Our output produces three tables, providing us with information about the factors SPSS found. Scroll down and locate the rotated component table to see how our variables are loading. It looks like our analysis found two factors. The empty spaces are the associations that SPSS ignores. Looking at the questions associated to each factor, it looks like factor 1 may be related to female self-confidence, and factor 2 may be related to female self-concept.